हेलो एवरीवन, आई रचना एच कलपनवर, लेक्चर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स डिपार्टमेंट, जैन पॉलिटेक्निक, बेलगावी। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू कवर अबाउट दी मेरिट्स एंड डी मेरिट्स और एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ अंडरग्राउंड एंड ओवरहेड सर्विस मेन फ्रॉम द सर्विस मेन्स यूनिट ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिकल एस्टिमेशन एंड कॉस्टिंग सब्जेक्ट। लाइक दिस एस्टिमेशन वीडियोज प्लीज़ डू सब्सक्राइब माई आर्किटेक्ट यूट्यूब चैनल। Let us see the contents of today's video. We'll see first overhead service main advantages and disadvantages, underground service main advantages and disadvantages. Next, we'll see the wire table. So one by one we'll see now. In the first, overhead service main. So advantages of overhead service main is, first one, it is a cheap, means less cost. Comparison with the underground, two types of the service mains are there, overhead and the underground service main. Compared to underground service main, overhead service main is cheap and it is easy to erect. Erection means installation. In the electrical terminology, for installation of all the substation or transformer and any overhead or underground service main, we will be using the word as a erection. So it is easy to erect compared to underground service main. Underground service main means we have to dig the earth and we have to connect the underground cable, but not in the case of overhead service main, it is easy compared to that. Next, fault location is also easy. It is a visible. It is a, you no need to anything like in underground service main, if any fault occurs, what happened? You have to dig the earth and you have to detect that fault and correction. But not in the case of, it is easily, in the case of overhead service main, you can easily locate fault location of the fault and correction is easy, it will be. And easy replacement. Yes, replacement means if something happen and if you want extension or something wire you have to replace and all, then it is a easy compared to underground service main. But in underground service main, for everything you have to dig the earth and you have to do the all the repair work and all, again you have to do connection. But not in the case of, so only it is for, because of all these things only overhead service mains are cheap. Then it's something, maybe disadvantages also will be there, no? Disadvantages is, first is appearance. Yes, it's not looking, if you see in beside your home wire connections and all, it will be there. So it is not looking good. So appearance is not good, ugly appearance you can tell. Next, weather condition. Weather condition means such as sun heat and rainy season, it may affect the wires. And not safe. Why it is not safe? Because either branches of the trees may be falling or birds like animals and like monkeys and all running over the line, then it is a dangerous, so it is not safe. Next, it may affect the lightning. Yes, it is open, but in rainy season lightning may occur, so it is also affected by lightning. So these are some advantages and disadvantages of the overhead service main. Next, we'll see the advantages and disadvantages of underground service main. So what are the advantages? First, we'll see now. Long life. Yes, it's compared to overhead service main, these are long life because it's secured. It is digging the earth and we covered hand. Next, it is connected. So it is a long life. Next, good appearance. Because it's not at all visible. It is under the earth, digging the earth and all under the ground it is. So no crumbling of wires and all will be there like in overhead service main. So it's a good appearance. Next, it is not affected by any weather condition. Next, it is a safety to the public. Next, we'll see the disadvantages. The disadvantages, yes, obviously it is a too much costly. So many advantages it is having means because again digging there and all cables also costly. So it is a costly, difficult to erection compared to the overhead service main. You have to again dig the earth and you have to do connections and all, again you have to close it, everything. It is a costly and it is a difficult, and fault location also difficult. It's not easy, everything in the underground service main, but it is a long life. And some other advantages also it is having, fault location and all, repair work, it will be problem. Next, it will be difficult to replace because whole cable is to be replaced, which is too costly. So because of this, so many disadvantages. And to connect this underground cable also skilled labor are required, but not in the overhead service main. Okay, no problem. Others, the okay person like connected, if they seen once they can connect, but not in the case of underground cable, it's skilled labors are required. One thing you can compare with the overhead and underground service main, Advantages, the whatever the advantages in the overhead servicemen will become a disadvantages for the underground, and overhead servicemen disadvantages will become the advantages of underground servicemen. You can observe in the previous slide, just I'll show. Okay, see here in the overhead servicemen, it's a cheap, there it's a costly. Easy to erect, difficult to erect. Easy fault location, difficult fault location. Easy replacement, difficult in replacement. See, all these, whatever the advantages will become the disadvantages in the overhead servicemen. Like this, in the disadvantages, appearance will not good here. The ugly appearance, there will be appearance good. The disadvantage, it will not have, if it will affected by the weather condition, there it will not affect by the weather condition. It's not safe, there is a safe. It's not, it will be affecting by lightning, there is, it will be not affecting by the lightning. So one only you can see, these all things, points you can remember. Only overhead servicemen, if you remember, underground servicemen will become easy for you. Like this, all the disadvantages will become the disadvantages. All the disadvantages of overhead servicemen will become the advantages of the underground servicemen. So like this, you can remember the comparison or advantages and disadvantages of the underground servicemen. Next, we'll see one wire table. What is this wire table? See, while solving the problem or while you people see, so many square mm conductors will be there, whether it may be aluminum or copper. Copper will be preferring for interior home wiring and aluminum will be preferring for the servicemen. That time what will happen? See, current will be find outing. How you are find outing the current for the single phase? I is equal to P by V, power divided by voltage. Voltage usually is for single phase 230. And power is how much? 1 kilowatt, 2 kilowatt. Like this current, if you calculate, again factor of safety will be including for that. After that, some current value will be getting. See, if your current value is within the 10 amp for the aluminum, then you will be taking the 1.5 square mm aluminum conductor. If your current value is within 16 amp, then you have to take the 2.5, 20, 4 square mm, 27, 6 square mm. Like this, you can select the aluminum conductor according to the current. This is the current column. This is about copper conductor. If for the, it is will helpful for the interior wiring, and this will be helpful for the servicemen. So for the interior wiring also same thing. If you, after I is equal to P by V, will be getting the current. Now that value, if it is the within 10 amp, then you can take the 1 square mm 1 by 18 SWG copper wire. If it is within 16 amps, then it is a 1.5 3 by 22 SWG. SWG is nothing but standard wire gauge indicating that number. 3 by 22 SWG copper will be using. If it is within 20, 2.5 square mm, 3 by 20 SWG copper wire is required. So like this, you have to select the wire. See, for all the amps, there will be no, that is not that you have to select only one type of cable, no. It's a different, according to the current capacity, the cable size is also different. So according to that, you have to do it. So again, better understanding you'll be getting by solving the some problem. In the next slide, that is next video, I'm going to solve some problems regarding the single phase overhead servicemen and three phase overhead servicemen, how you are installing, what are the materials required, and again single phase underground servicemen and also three phase underground servicemen. So these are the some problems regarding the servicemen and how much is the cost for estimation of that, how much and all, and what are the materials required and how much materials will be required, that will I'm going to cover in the coming videos. So I hope you people understood about the comparison or advantages and disadvantages of underground and overhead servicemen and also wire table.